do you do that?
It's the one place where a child can feel more at home than home.
Set, go.
A playground.
And it's a great way to bring people together.
Go on, Rob.
And on this day in Lake St. Louis, it would have been hard to measure smiles per hour.
We come up here and he has freedom.
This particular playground is 10-year-old Zach Blakemore's favorite. And it was built not with a hammer and nails.
We've been so excited.
But with stubbornness and conviction.
Man. He just teaches you to get up and keep going. You know, it's amazing.
Zachary was born with a rare nervous system disorder called Pelizaeus-Merzbacher disease.
It's a leukodystrophy, which means his brain lacks myelin.
The disease is progressive. The doctors told the Blakemores that Zach would never be able to stand on his own and likely wouldn't live past his 15th birthday.
To have this take him eventually, I try not to think about
it. You want to be player number two now?
There would be no counting the days. Instead, they were determined to make every day count for their son. Much of the time, you can find Zach inside playing with his two younger sisters.
Video games. Yeah. So he loves playing the Wii.
An outside playground used to be out of the question. They tried it once, but Zach didn't have enough trunk support to even be safe in a swing.
I went home and cried and promised I would never go back. I was done with playgrounds.
But on a trip to Washington, D.C. to visit family, they were taken to a playground that was truly accessible. Zach was able to get around in both his wheelchair and his walker.
All of a sudden, kids were interacting and playing with him that had never really happened before.
Even before they got back home, the Blakemores were already trying to figure out ways to bring that kind of playground to the St. Louis area.
And then what does Ian make? This disease has taken everything from my child and eventually will.
No, you sound it out.
And I could not give him anything back. I couldn't make his legs work. I can't make him speak better. But I found something I could give back to him.
So Natalie went to work. Hundreds of phone calls, handshakes, and fundraisers.
$750,000 was our goal.
She even convinced the community of Lake St. Louis to donate the acreage.
And I was so excited. And Todd came home from work that day, and I just said, "We have land."
I'm like, land for what?
Yeah.
And 4 years later, the Blakemores turned an empty lot to a ribbon-cutting ceremony in a place now known as Zachary's Playground.
We're able to watch, you know, the kids rush in, and it was a great sense of accomplishment.
Though it was built with disabled children like 11-year-old Gracie Gibson in mind,
we're just amazed. I mean, we're really honestly amazed.
Zachary's Playground is a destination for able-bodied children as well.
Actually, our whole family can come and have a good time.
Woo!
The Blakemores have started their own nonprofit organization in the hopes of building accessible playgrounds all over the St. Louis area, and then perhaps all over the country. With a message that comes through loud and clear.
To make life the very best that you can, no matter what your struggles are.
Apparently, with enough determination, there's no such thing as limitation.
It's amazing. It just seems unreal that it was a dream that's here.